Cayetano Fernandez. He's a co-founder and activist of the anti-racist collective Kale Amenge, which focuses on the self-organization of the Roma people as a political subject and producing political theoretical tools for collective Roma emancipation. He is currently conducting research at the Center for Social Studies at the University of Coimbra, analyzing the epistemological reproduction of anti-Roma racism in Romani studies. Fernandez co-edited State Racism, a collective overview from the perspective of autonomy and racial justice, and published articles like Anti-Roma Racism and the White Academic Agenda, Tasks, Disputes and Challenges of Roma Political Anti-Racism and Anti-Roma Racism, Social Work and the White Civilizing Mission in Various Contexts and Languages. Cayetano, I mean, this is the big question. I mean, it's for all of us. What is the vision of Roma for Europe? It's a big question.
It's a big question.
You will get all this question because, I mean, it's we are working all of this, on this.
Okay, from my view, I don't know, there is a lot of depending in this to solve this this question. No? The first thing I think we need to address is going to depend if the Roma movement is able to overcome the deep political crisis that is right now involved, and if it's able to, and if we are able to overcome the white political domination in which we are. No? This is the fair question I believe we need to address. No? Of course, there is many things. We just listened in Vicente, no? And other brother and sister in this Congress bringing ideas that I can agree with the most of them. But just to be brief, I want to speak here. I'm not going to speak about demand to the state or to government or to parliament or this kind of thing. To be honest with you, at the state of the Roma struggle right now, I don't expect much for government, state, European Union, or whatever other institution, but I would like to use this time that I am having the floor to address some thought to you, to my brother and sister here in this Congress, and I'm going to focus only on two things, coherency and political autonomy. But in order to make clear what do I mean by this coherency and political autonomy, I think that we need to make some clarification in of how we understand the struggle. Because nowadays, it seems like everyone is speaking about the same thing when we are speaking about anti-racist struggle, confronting anti-gypsism or anti-Roma racism, but then the political translation is not the same. So I want to clarify how do I see this struggle. The first thing, for me, this struggle is not about to make an appendix, like a Roma appendix, to any political party, no matter lefty or right or whatever other thing. My struggle is not to make cosmetic changes in the same. I'm not aiming to put one Roma face here in this institution, other Roma face there, just to make some cosmetic because it looks nice, but then it doesn't bring radical changes and structural changes. And of course, in my view, the struggle is not about to build a kind of moralist project where we are trying to convince Gaje that we are not this that they thought that we were, no? Because there is a lot on this, we can find a lot on this idea of the rehumanizing, no? No, you need to take into consideration the contribution that Roma in history, blah, 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 no? And then what we end up with dealing with projects for Gagella, like, hey, come to know the Roma history. Like in 600 years, they didn't have time to know us. And it's not true at the end, you know? It's like I believe that police, for example, know very well Roma people or courtyard, this kind of thing, no? So in this thing, I think the first thing we need to do is to allocate, to be clear what we are confronting here. And what we are confronting here is a structural system of domination built and alive for more than 500 years. So this is not about changing some wrong idea in Gaje's people's mind. is an entire system that we need to confront. And of course, with such a huge demon in front of us, there is no magical receipt. There is not going to be just like simple thing to address. But I think we need to understand a few questions in order to be clear what we are confronting. And the first thing I think we need to understand is that anti-Gypsyism or anti-Roman racism, as you prefer, is not an accident in European history. It's not a casualty. Anti-Roman racism is in the very DNA of the European project, in the modern European project. European modernity is based in a racial order, in a racial idea to sustain and maintain Gallic supremacy. So we need to understand this, because this should have an impact in how we organize ourselves, which kind of allies we want to build. Because maybe we need to stop looking up to parliament and all this kind of thing, and we need to look more around to other racialized people that are in the same struggle we were. Because at the end, this European project, at the same time that they were colonizing other land and trying to civilize them, they need the inner enemy. Our role in the European history is to become this inner enemy. This idea, no? I was speaking this morning also with some of our brother and sister in the Warsaw, no? When I was saying, like, for me, the difference between the Gypsy and the Roma is the Gypsy is just a fiction. It's a white creation that only it's only seen in white people mind, in the Gallic mind. But this fictional creation have a deep political impact. I mean, they have been educating their children during centuries based on this idea. They need like to create this idea of the Gypsy to educate the children and say, you see these savages? This is what you never should become. And this is nowadays we have a translation of this, and it's what we call integration. What is integration? What have been or this political framework or this public policy based on integration? The only impact this has is what we define as a civilizatorian vision. It's the same idea. So most of these political public policy and project, they are not aimed to solve our problem as a Roma or our families. Is more connected with how they create this idea that they are superior, they are the civilized one, and they want to civilize it. No? Of course, this create all this problem that also Vicente was speaking now about the distance between community and the movement. Because, of course, when they are fundraising or this project, they come with the agenda. And our people in the ghetto, in the Mahala, they cannot relate with that. When they come with real problems, they say, no, I have a project, but my project cannot help you. Because my project is more about civilizing you, about teach you to take your children on time in the school. You know, on this kind of question. And this has one more tricky impact, if you want. It's create this idea that, in my view, it's a trap, and I believe that many brothers and sisters are falling this trap, that collaborating with the system is going to help us. So they create this kind of theater where, okay, they speak to us about political participation, so let's put one Roma here, let's put other Roma there, and this, they believe, is going to make any change. But I don't think that we need to make a deep research to realize that the problem here is not that the system is failing. The real problem here is that the system is working perfectly, because the system is designed in order to maintain Gallic supremacy and to control politically our voices. So this has other consequences, is the creation of an artificial political subject that speak in our name but has nothing to do with us. That don't bring our agenda. They don't bring our demand. So at the end, what they are is, by collaborating with the enemy, they are reinforcing it. Because let me ask you something here, brother and sister. Do you know any case of oppressed nation that had get liberated by sitting in the same table with the oppressor and discussing with them? So we need to address all this question, because this idea of is integration, you know, I mean, I speak sometimes about integrationism, that is more than integration, because there are people now that they don't say integration, now they say inclusion or multiculturality or whatever other euphemism, or don't mention at all, but integrationism have a huge impact in our people, because the impact of integrationism is to put this idea that we need white people to be safe, that we are not enough working alone, no? I know, for example, I know you remember, I'm sure you remember, because during last year, thanks to the anti-racist Roma movement, the death of Roma people like Stanislav Toma in Czech Republic, or Daniel Jimenez, or many other brothers that have died because of police brutality, always in this kind of cases, I hear one Roma that say, what we need here is more Roma in the police. Such a stupid idea. I mean, this for me is the final triumph of anti-gypsism, of integrationism, is when I hear this kind of thing. So we have an institution that is erasing our people, killing our people, and still to call for the abolition of this institution, you wish to be part of it? Of course, we need to address all this question, because it's matter a lot in which kind of political project we want to be involved. And also we need to question some of this narrative. Even in this Congress we have here, and we are all used to hear about why the gadget politician that come to speak to us about democracy, about human rights, about rule of law, about all this question. But then we all know here, or if we all know, I think a good portion of brother and sister here, we are very aware that when it comes to Roma, these are just empty words and goodwill, no? So here is where we need to, I believe we need to address this question of cosmetic changing. I think we are in a very critical situation right now in the movement. I believe that we have made a step forward in the sense that 10 years ago, most of the Roma organizations, they don't even speak about racism. The only narrative was integration. Now we have the question of racism in the table. We have the question of resistance to build a proud generation of our people, but then this question also comes with the necessity to be coherent. Because the big brother, the big system, is always waiting for you to co-opt. And then we end up with people, the same people that were working about integration, that now present projects about resistance and get funded because of this. So I think what we need to claim here is, if you claim resistance, please resist. Because if not, we are making the enemy stronger, no? So, just to summarize, to finish soon, because I'm speaking too much, no? I was saying, we need to react again all this question. We are we have the right also to be anger. We were discussing also about this question. And to react when, can this committee discourse about human rights, democracy, when we know that from tomorrow, when finish this Congress and we go back to our house, what we are going to find in the ghetto, in the Mahalla, is the same thing always. It's harassment, it's police brutality, it's mass incarceration, it's school segregation, no? So let's learn the history. Let's learn from this history of our movement. We're discussing a lot in this Congress about that, and let's don't make the same mistake. Maybe let's create a new mistake. And maybe from this we can move, but we are in a very crucial situation, because what we are facing right now in Europe is a slow genocide. It's a slow genocide decorated with fancy war, with fancy, with the question of, you know, human rights and all this question that I was saying, no? So in this context, I believe the only way for us is to build this, what we define, political autonomy. Of course, political autonomy is a very complex issue. The center racism is a very complex issue. And can come from very simple understanding, like we were saying, autonomy, what does mean autonomy at the very simple level? Not to be dependent. Break with the dependency of the to the white world. To a more elaborate and complex understanding that we will see where we can be. But at the beginning, the first thing, I think all this start, all this idea of autonomy starts in how we believe in ourselves, how we think about ourselves. If we are constantly thinking as a victim and as dependent people, we cannot break with this. We need, because this decade of integrationism has put this idea that I say that we are not good enough to work alone, that we need the gadget people. We need to break with this poison ideologies in order to create an emancipatory path. No? And then there is one thing that I love about this question of autonomy. It's like, autonomy is something that you exercise. You don't need to have permission for nobody to exercise autonomy. It's how we create our political path. It's the same that happened with emancipation. That's why I love the word emancipation. Because emancipation doesn't accept any passive form. Or you emancipate yourself, or nobody's going to emancipate you. Or the Roman nation emancipates itself, or nobody's going to come to emancipate that. But for that, in order to achieve this situation, I think we need somehow, and understand me, I'm not going to say this in advance, but we need to stop paying respect to the white world, to believe in that the only way to war is with the white institution, that they want to be part of this state and form of rule and government and create our own, no? And of course, this requires a high degree, I believe, what I was saying before, of political coherence, because, and I finish with that, let me be clear, because we cannot be naive of the situation that has Roma movement we are right now. There are a lot of people that fall in love with all this white war and institution, but I want to be very clear about this question. When there is a situation of oppressor and oppressed, let's also understand that when we are speaking about anti-Roma racism, and they say it's a structural issue, and some people believe that, well, it's structural, so nobody is responsible. No, structural means that the main face of the anti-Roma racism is the state, is the institution, so they are responsible. So what I would say, in this situation of oppressor and oppressed, you cannot be loyal to both sides. There is no space in between. Because this discourse is very common. No, I'm working for you, but I'm working also with the oppressor. We need to be, and I finish here, no, with this with the idea that we need to demand also accountability. I think it's kind of time to demand for accountability of the impact, the political impact of the Roma movement.
Yeah. Sorry, thank you, I speak too much. Fernandez. Yeah, maybe just let it a bit shorter to have after that a little debate.